Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see about different chart types that Power BI supports. There are two types, common chart types and Power BI specific chart types. There is no general rule in Microsoft, they come up with this. Basically, these are the common chart types in the sense all the BI tools or any reporting tools use this, and Power BI specific is like more or less only used in Power BI. So with that note, let us explore our business scenario to refresh. A person is owning Naga garments. For him, we are building a dashboard. He is selling men's casual, accessories, and ladies casual. Let's see these chart types in a demo. So already we have built this dashboard. If you haven't seen that, you please go and watch. And you see here a stacked bar chart, and these are different charts, okay, cluster charts, all those things. So this is a clustered column chart, and when I want to change it to bar chart, it immediately changes. So the difference is the axis. Yeah, I mean it's like x-axis and y-axis, and now you see the Q1 Q2 in x-axis. Earlier it was in y-axis. That is the main difference. And you have a stacked column chart in which you can have multiple measures or multiple items over it. In this example, we are seeing two measures, selling price and item amount, whereas you can see this in bar charts as well. So these are different charts. I'm trying to explain what is the stack chart and what is the bar charts and how to use this one and when to choose those things. I will cover it later. Let's see another chart, like line chart. So usually it will be used in comparison in trend, and if you have two measures, so line charts will be more useful. Let's copy this chart and I'll make it as a column chart. I'll copy it again. I just want to explore this line and stacked column chart, how it was designed or how we can draw this chart. And copy and paste. So what I'm saying is, in this chart we have a column chart and two measures, selling price and item amount. Along with this, I want to have a item quantity to be also viewed in this chart. So click on that chart, sorry, this one, and item quantity in line series. So in a single chart you can able to analyze some multiple things like selling price, item amount across the trend, and item quantity as well. Various charts available based on their business scenario. You need to choose appropriate charts. Let's see our previous dashboard here. And this is the typical example of a pie chart on shop or order online, and we have a donut chart here. Both are similar, and when to choose these charts is like you have very few items here. I mean, either like categorizing one or two items, like either male or female, something like that. Let us see when I have item amount here, what happens. So if you see here, the item amount over here, if it's viewed in bar chart, it is clear. But when I see it in pie chart, it is unclear. It makes obvious, like when, if you choose the wrong chart, it gives a wrong intention, or you cannot analyze much. So that is what I'm trying to convey. So choose the chart wisely based on the data available, and you can analyze it better. So we covered most of the common charts. Now I want to explore the map. So map, I'm going to use this location column. So he has branches in three locations, and let us explore that one in map chart. So you can have multiple pages. Click on this map. So this option, there are other maps as well. We will see it later. Now expand it. And when I use location, then immediately this chart will come up. And when I put it here, then the location is narrowed down to where the data exists. I don't just want to change the property. I want to change this map style. Just I'll choose grayscale. Looks somewhat better. Light. I think we'll go for grayscale. This looks better. And I want to change this bubble size as well. Again, click on this. Go to bubbles. Change the size. So these are the properties window for any charts you need to change. With this visual, he can able to analyze that what are my best performing locations, what is my least performing locations. So that is the main purpose of these business intelligence tools. Visualize the data to understand your business better. So that's it about map, and we will have the data card is one of the Power BI specific. So here I can use a single data card. This is a single data card. I am using a measure, and this used to show single value. It is a numerical value. I am going for a second chart, that is multi-row card. This, let us explore it by choosing some measures. I can have multiple measures. So measures is nothing but your numerical value that can be aggregated. So when you choose this one, before this, I want to show that single data card, the item amount. When I choose item quantity here, it changes to item quantity. I can either see either item amount or item quantity. That is your single row card. Whereas multi-row card, you can have multiple measures. That is the main difference. And along with this, I can also have other categorical values as well, the order type. So I can see now the on shop and online order as well. So this is what multi-row card is. And I want to change one of the property, the feature I like, that is bar. Oh, it's not here. I think it's in bar. Yes. So let me increase the thickness to 10. Yes, it looks somewhat better. So like this, if you change some of the properties, the row card or multi-row card, that will look better. Let us see another visual now. Table. So it's a plain table kind of information, but unlike other, I mean, source data, it aggregates your values. So it's like it's not same like your data over here. You see like aggregated value. The selling price is your aggregated value. Tax amount is aggregated value. It's basically group by of your categorical value, and the selling price and tax amount is summed up based or it is whatever aggregated set on those selling price and tax amount. So that is what this table is all about. Let's see another visual, matrix. So matrix is your pivot table. Those who are familiar with Excel, they are aware of it. So choose columns, and I want in column level, item name, and I can choose any of the measures, item quantity. There you go. So this is typical matrix behavior or pivot table behavior. You can see the data rows and column wise with some aggregated values. So this is what matrix table is all about. There are certain formattings you can do. For now, I'll just move it at top. Another interesting feature I like is like Question and answer. The question and answer is like you can ask your natural language question, something like what is my total sales, what is my selling price, what is my total item quantity, like that. Instead of you understand the data, if you ask what you want, then you get answer. That is your question and answer. I think I misspelled it. Let me correct. Yes, so this 4 million is nothing but your 3.97 million. It's rounded off to 4 million. Now, if I ask some other measure or some other value, some other question basically, I want what is my total item quantity? Then it should return 4766. Yes, we got the answer. So first we have to cover another feature like filters. We already have filters, and when to use these filters, people will ask this question. So there are multiple purpose we need to go for filter options, and one of the options I'm going to show it to you. So choose this slicer. We call it as a slicer. It's not a filter basically. So choose location. Here, if you choose any of the checkbox, it will filter the data. Same behavior it will do when you put it in filter. But sometimes we need to change it in some other way, or behavior of the charts to be changed. For now, just watch this example. I want to change this orientation so it looks like a tab. So such a kind of things, if you want to enable, you need to go for such visuals, slices. So this is the reason we need to go for such options instead of going for filters. One of the reason, okay? This is not the actual reason we will go for it. There are a lot of other reasons we need to use slices instead of filters. Okay, guys, I hope guys we are done with this video. If you guys like this video, please share this video and subscribe to this channel. Do remember that data is your asset, and join our group below mentioned in the description for further discussions and clarifications.